Students, whatever homework is given to you, you have to submit it on the very next day between 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. to the given WhatsApp number, and it is compulsory to submit your homework as your attendance will be marked on the basis of your submission.
Okay, good morning students. Welcome to the online classes. Yesterday we have studied
Chapter
3, Chapter 4, Probability. We have done its introduction, its degrees of probability, its history of probability, and we have solved some of the sums of exercise 15.5. Now today we are going to solve next sums of exercise 15.5. So question number 7. The survey of 200 students, whether they like or like statistics or not, that is done. So total number of trials is 200. Now the data collected is the opinion of the students whether they like or dislike statistics. So 135 students like statistics, while 66 students don't like statistics. So now we may have to find the probability of the event where the students like statistics. Now here the number of trials 200. Out of that, if you want to find out the probability of the event where the students like statistics, let us denote it by PA, where PA denotes the probability of the event where the students like statistics is number of favorable outcomes support total outcomes. Number of favorable outcomes. Outcome upon total number of or total outcome. So favorable outcomes are how many students like statistics, what is the data given, in that 135 students like statistics, and total number of students is 200. So now next probability, found out the probability of the student probability where the student does not like statistics. Now 66 students does not like statistics. So probability of the event where the student does not like statistics P is equal to PB. We will denote this probability as PB. Now PB is equal to number of favorable outcomes. Here the favorable outcomes are 66, while total outcomes are 200. Total outcomes are 200. Now, next question, 11, question number 11. So, 11 bags of wheat flour, each mark 5 kg. The bag is marked with 5 kg. But actual weight of the wheat flour in each bag is less than or more than or equal to 5 kg. The data is given. Now, these 11 observations are given. Now, out of these 11 observations, we have to find out the probability of the event where the bag chosen at random contains more than 5 kg. So 11 total number of observations or total number of outcomes are 11. So probability of the event where the bag chosen at random contains more than 5 kg, total outcomes are 11. Now first step, count the number of bags which are more than 5 kg of the weight. So what, this is first, second, third, fourth, fifth, sixth, and seventh. So this four, seven pack, these seven packs have the weight more than 5 kg, 5.08, 5.06, 5.08 in kg, 5.04, 5.07, and 5.03. So these are seven such packs have weight more than 5 kg. So probability of the event where the pack chosen at random contains more than 5 kg is number of favorable outcomes divided by total number of outcomes. Favorable outcomes are 7, total outcomes are 11. So which is 7 by 11. Now some questions of this exercise 15.1, they are related to chapter 14 statistics. Now as we have not finished chapter statistics, we will directly use the data which is given in that chapter. So for the 6th question, refer table 14.7 chapter 14. The data is entered here. The marks obtained by 90 students, total number of students is 90, and the marks obtained, it is given here. So out of that, we have to find out the probability of the event where the student obtained less than 20% marks. Now less than 20% marks means this. How many students got less than 20% marks? 7. So number of where the probability of event A, where A denotes the students obtained less than 20% marks. So here favorable outcomes are 7, while total number of students are 90. So probability of the event where students obtained less than 20% marks is 7 by 20. Next question is, the student obtained marks more than 60 or more than that means this one. Now this 50 to 60, this 60 marks are included in next group, that is 60 to 70 and more than 70. So total of this 15 plus 8, that is 23. Total of 15 plus 8 is 23. So probability of event, when favorable, first we will see a favorable outcome. Favorable outcome, sum total of last two, that is 15 plus 8, which is 23. Now probability of the event is denoted by P, where the students obtained marks 60 or more than that. So 23 students got marks 60 or more than that, and total number of students is 90. So this probability is 23 upon 90. So this first probability and total number of students is 90. So probability of the first event where the student obtained less than 20% mark is 7 upon 90, while that of next is 23 upon 90. Now this last question of this exercise 15.1. Now this is related to last question number 13. It is related to exercise 14.2, question number 1, where the groups of different students are given and total number of students are 30. Now it is from chapter of statistics. We will directly use the data from chapter statistics, and now here we have to determine the probability of the student of this class selected at random as blood group AB. Blood group AB. Probability of the event where the selected student has blood group AB. Selected student has blood group AB. So we keep 3 upon total number of students 30. So favorable outcomes are 3, total number of students are 30. Therefore, probability of this event is 1 by 30.